invite you to take part in them and shape them through your mind and your body. During this ceremony, the ceiling is in static. We'll be moving around. And at one point, I will ask you to lay down on the floor on the side of the space. If you don't want to, just let me know before. And the choreography
art addresses everybody in the hope of making an impression, above all of being felt, of being the cause of an emotional trauma and being accepted, of winning people not by incontrovertible rational argument, but through the spiritual energy with which the artist has charged the work. And the preparatory discipline it demands is not a scientific education, but a particular spiritual lesson. Art is born and takes hold wherever there is a timeless and insatiable longing for the spiritual, for the ideal. That longing which draws people to art. Modern art has taken a wrong turn in abandoning the search for the meaning of existence in order to affirm the value of the individual for its own sake. What purports to be art begins to look like an eccentric occupation for suspect characters who maintain that any personalized action is of intrinsic value simply as a display of self-will. But in artistic creation, the personality does not assert itself. It serves another, higher, and communal idea. The artist is always a servant and is perpetually trying to pay for the gift that has been given to him as if by miracle. Modern man, however, does not want to make any sacrifice, even though true affirmation of self can only be expressed in sacrifice. We are gradually forgetting about this, and at the same time, inevitably losing all sense of our human calling. When I speak of the aspiration towards the beautiful, of the ideal as the ultimate aim of art, which grows from a yearning for that ideal, I am not for a moment suggesting that art should shun the dirt of the world. On the contrary, the artistic image is always a metonym where one thing is substituted for another, the smaller for the greater. To tell of what is living, the artist uses something dead. To speak of the infinite, he shows the finite. Substitution. The infinite cannot be made into matter, but it is possible to create an illusion of the infinite, the image.
Thank you.
will now be given a delicate object that you should balance on your mouth. In your own pace, sit up and place the blanket that's lying next to you over your shoulders. And as we're approaching the end, we will shortly invite you to lie down and find a comfortable position. You can close your eyes, relax, and take your time. When you're ready, wake up